From the most complete dino remains to the earliest feathered creatures. Stay tuned to number one to learn about the most incredible dinosaur finds of all time. Number 10, Nodosaur. A group of miners were incredibly fortunate to come across one of the best preserved fossils found to date. However, it has only been in the last year that paleontologists have been able to completely unearth and move a large section of the fossil. This specimen is of a newly discovered species of Nodosaur, a type of Thyreophora often overshadowed by its cereal box famous cousin, the Stegosaurus. As it lumbered across the landscape between 110 million and 112 million years ago, almost midway through the Cretaceous period, the 18-foot-long, nearly 3,000-pound behemoth was the rhinoceros of its day, a grumpy herbivore that largely kept to itself. As with many of the other well-armored herbivores, this creature had the perfect defense for when a predator comes calling. Two 20-inch-long spikes jutting out of its shoulders like a misplaced pair of bull's horns. When the miners unearthed the find, they knew immediately that it was something unlike anything they'd ever seen before. The amazing level of fossilization, which was caused by its rapid undersea burial, is incredibly rare and has offered scientists a unique opportunity to research this species in detail. Usually just the bones and teeth are preserved, but on this occasion, a lot more of the animal was fossilized. Number 9. The Velociraptor and Protoceratops. Here we have perhaps the coolest find ever, which was discovered in the Gobi Desert of Mongolia in 1971 and is 74 million years old. Before we hear about it though, I'd really appreciate it if you take a moment to subscribe to our channel for more videos from Zero to Hero. While you're there, be sure to click the little notification bell and like this video. This fossil is the preserved remains of a Velociraptor and a Protoceratops, who are now eternally attached to one another. No one knows exactly how they ended up like this, but there are a couple of different theories. One theory suggests that the Velociraptor was fighting the Protoceratops when they were covered by a landslide. One feature of the fossil which might support this is that the Velociraptor has sunk its deadly foot claw deep into the neck of the Protoceratops, and the Protoceratops appears to have thrown the Velociraptor to the ground with its jaw locked on the predator's right arm. However, others have interpreted it differently, such as those who give more credence to the theory that the Velociraptor was feasting on the Protoceratops when they were both covered in the landslide. However they got there, thankfully their remains have offered us a glimpse into the distant past. Number 8. Andrew Carnegie's Diplodocus. Sometimes people are fortunate enough to find exactly what they're looking for, and such is the case with Andrew Carnegie. After amassing a small fortune and opening his own museum, Carnegie wanted to get his hands on impressive dinosaur skeletons. So, he financed expeditions to northern Wyoming and southern Utah to find some. Luckily, he did, and was even fortunate enough to find a complete skeleton of the biggest dinosaur discovered to date, named Diplodocus Carnegie, or Carnegie's Double Beam. The entire animal was over 82 feet long and dwarfed in size and completeness anything else that had been discovered up to that point in time. It roamed the planet 155 to 45 million years ago and feasted on the leaves at the top of trees thanks to its very long neck. It's not surprising that Carnegie was so happy with his find that he had casts of it sent to museums around the world. Number 7. Mama Oviraptor. This is a find of a brooding mother who was sitting on her nest of eggs when disaster struck between 83 and 66 million years ago. Found in 1994 in the Gobi Desert, Mongolia, this find helped us rewrite our understanding of the Oviraptor. When the first one was unearthed in 1922, the species was incorrectly given the name associated with egg thief due to its proximity to a group of eggs which were originally believed to belong to Protoceratops. However, later finds suggested that this interpretation was incorrect, and that the Oviraptor was in fact likely the parent, not an egg thief at all. The 1994 discovery helped cement this belief, as the fossil was more or less complete, only missing its head, and it was sitting on a nest, positioned in exactly the same way modern birds incubate their own eggs. When alive, the species was one of the most bird-like of the theropod dinosaurs, with several features similar to modern birds. Number 6. Mother giving birth. If there's anything certain in this world, it's that everything can change in a matter of seconds. An animal can be going about its business one moment and gone the next. Well, we have another such example here. This incredibly unique fossil is of a mother ichthyosaur who is in the process of delivering at least 3 offspring, and who is believed to have passed during the birthing process. Discovered in South Majiashan, China in 2011, this fossil is around 248 million years old. Amazingly, one of the offspring was found still half inside its mother, while a second was found under the mother, and the third still inside, waiting to be born. Because of the position of the find, it's unlikely that the babies were expelled from their mother after death, according to researchers. The skeleton was a lucky find because it was found with another skeleton from a completely different time period. Number 5. Houska Raptor. So far, we've covered some fairly normal-looking dinosaurs. Well, what you might expect dinosaurs to look like. But now, we're going to delve into the weird and wonderful world of bird-like dinosaurs. Most of us will agree, as would most paleontologists, that birds have descended from dinosaurs. Features that were once solely attributed to bird species have, in recent years, been found widespread amongst theropod dinosaurs, the group of dinosaurs that ultimately gave rise to birds. Nevertheless, even this next discovery is one no one could have predicted. This new species of non-avian theropod dinosaurs have a long neck, measuring about 50% of its total length, and kind of looks like a swimmer to some extent. What this recent find does highlight is that there are a lot more variety of dinosaurs still waiting to be discovered. And what this particular investigation demonstrates is how modern advancements in paleontology and advances in scientific instruments have enabled paleontologists to study fossils non-invasively with high-tech 3D scanning. So there goes the familiar image of a paleontologist with a digging tool and a small brush. Number 4. Sinisteropteryx. Some of the most interesting feathered dinosaurs have been unearthed across Asia in recent decades. The most notable finds come from China and are completely rewriting the history of feathered dinosaurs. These finds are considered by many to be further examples of missing links between dinosaurs and birds. The Sinisteropteryx was one of the first of many amazing finds to come out of China's Liaoning Quarry and was first discovered in 1997. The longest known specimen reaches up to 1.7 meters, or 3.5 feet, in length, with an estimated weight of 0.55 kilograms, or 1.2 pounds. This well-preserved fossil portrays the unmistakable impression of primitive, hair-like feathers, which, at the time, was the first time paleontologists had ever directly detected this feature on a dinosaur. The nature of the hair-like feathers suggests that feathers evolved from a much simpler structure that probably functioned as an insulator, and, as you're about to see, feathers evolved in some interesting and colorful ways. Number 3. Anchiornis. This next one is another example that was also unearthed in China in 2009. Ankylosaurus, which is Greek for almost bird, roamed the forest of Asia around 155 million years ago. It measures about a foot long and weighs only a few ounces. It has unusually long front arms and feathers on its front limbs, hind limbs, and feet. Since the first fossil was unearthed, numerous additional examples of the same species has been found, and a team of scientists has analyzed the fossilized pigment cells of a specimen, resulting in what may be the first full-color depiction of an extinct dinosaur. Number 2. Hong Juju. Since 1996, nearly 50 new feathered dinosaur species have emerged from the fossil fields of China. The Hong Juju, which is Mandarin for rainbow with a big crest, is one of these, and has gained its name because scientists believe it had feathers that may have glittered with the colors of the rainbow, similar to modern-day hummingbirds. This duck-sized animal lived in forests and may have glided from tree to tree. So why so colorful? Well, many believe the feathers initially developed for display and wooing prospective partners, and that the vivid variety of colors may suggest that these dinosaurs, like modern and ancient birds, may have had colored vision. So what about flight? Well, this bird likely didn't fly at all, but simply glided. However, the Kaehong's frond-like tail has asymmetrical feathers, and their short, stiff leading edges could have supported flight. Kaehong is now the oldest known animal to have this key adaptation, something which is notable in other bird-like dinosaurs which lived 10 million years later, like Archaeopteryx. Number 1. Zegnalong Suey. Considered the biggest ever winged dinosaur found, the Zegnalong Suey was unearthed in China and lived 125 million years ago, sharing the planet with many other large and small dinosaurs, as well as amphibians and salamanders. Measuring 2 meters tall, it had short arms and dramatic plumage, from the tiny crown on its head to the quill-like feathers that extended from his wings and tail. Although its closest cousin is the Velociraptor, the dinosaur that helped make Jurassic Park films so terrifying, it looks more like a bird than its cousin. Due to the size of the creature, scientists don't believe its wings were used for flight, but instead, they hypothesize that they were used for colorful mating displays, or for protecting the eggs. Altogether, the sheer size of this creature and its rather bizarre look will definitely help rewrite what we consider a scary dino. I'm thinking the next Jurassic Park films might actually have some of these newly discovered feathered creatures. Which dinosaur was your favorite? Let us know in the comments below and take care!